Tuesday, 2:37 p.m. You are mid-bite into lunch when your phone buzzes. But when you glance at it, there's nothing. No missed call, no text, just silence. You brush it off. But later that evening, your battery plummets 15% while idle. Your camera light flickers once. You convince yourself it's a glitch. What if I told you it wasn't?
Pegasus can do things on your phone that you can't even do.
It can activate any function on your phone. It completely mirrors it.
Early Pegasus needed you to click a dodgy SMS link. Today, it doesn't. It's what's called a zero-click exploit. You don't touch anything. The spyware piggybacks on apps like iMessage or WhatsApp calls. Sometimes you don't even need to answer the call. Once in, Pegasus has root access. It can read your messages, even encrypted ones. Turn on mic and camera silently. Track your GPS. Capture every keystroke, every password, every OTP. Imagine this. You dump your phone, buy a new one, new SIM, new Apple ID. But days later, your contacts say, "You sent me something weird." You didn't. Forensics reveal it wasn't even your phone that got hit. It was your driver's phone because his calendar synced with yours. Pegasus didn't need you. It only needed someone close enough to your digital shadow. Welcome back to Decoding Cybersecurity. I'm Rakesh Nayam, and today we dive into the shadowy world of Pegasus spyware. The malware ghost that doesn't wait for you to click anything. Yes, you heard that right. Chapter 1, The Opening, The Invisible Knock. Tuesday, 2:37 p.m. You're mid-bite into lunch when your phone buzzes. But when you glance at it, there's nothing. No missed call, no text, just silence. You brush it off. But later that evening, your battery plummets 15% while idle. Your camera light flickers once. You convince yourself it's a glitch. What if I told you it wasn't?
Pegasus can do things on your phone that you can't even do.
It can activate any function on your phone. It completely mirrors it.
Amnesty International reports on a massive leak of 50,000 phone numbers.
I think what the project is showing is a breadth and a scale of the abuse.
At the center of the probe is the Pegasus spyware.
It can look for your cameras. It can also take pictures.
It accesses your messages, your history.
It can listen to what you say and can also record you.
So yeah, Pegasus is pretty terrifying.
Chapter 2, The Setup, The Creation of Pegasus Inside NSO Shadow Labs. Pegasus was built by NSO Group, a company near Tel Aviv founded in 2010. They market it as a tool for governments to fight terrorists and criminals. But leaks, like the Pegasus project in 2021, showed a darker reality. 50,000 phone numbers appeared on potential target lists. Journalists, activists, politicians, even France 24 reporters. NSO denies wrongdoing, but the evidence is staggering. Chapter 3, The Real Attack, Zero-Click Terror. Early Pegasus needed you to click a dodgy SMS link. Today, it doesn't. It's what's called a zero-click exploit. You don't touch anything. The spyware piggybacks on apps like iMessage or WhatsApp calls. Sometimes you don't even need to answer the call. Once in, Pegasus has root access. It can read your messages, even encrypted ones. Turn on mic and camera silently. Track your GPS. Capture every keystroke, every password, every OTP. Chapter 4, The Real Incidents, When It Happened For Real. 2016, UAE dissident Ahmed Mansour was targeted with Pegasus SMSs. Apple patched the exploit after Citizen Lab exposed it. 2019, WhatsApp sued NSO, alleging 1,400 users were targeted via a missed call exploit. 2021, the Pegasus project revealed widespread targeting, including heads of state, activists, and at least one France 24 staff member. 2021, Apple sued NSO and introduced lockdown mode in iOS 16. 2021, the U.S. Commerce Department blacklisted NSO.
So how does Pegasus get into your phone, and what does it do once it's actually in your phone?
Right, so it's an incredibly powerful bit of malware because it can slip in so easily, and once it's there, it can do pretty much anything. So an older iteration actually relied on something called spear phishing, which is where you receive a text message or an email, it's got a malicious link, you inadvertently click the link and it installs this software. Now though, it's able to reach phones using something called a ZeroClick attack, which is as scary as it sounds. It means it can exploit a vulnerability in one of the apps on your phone without any interaction from yourself. So we don't know all the examples of how it might use this, but one has been WhatsApp. Pegasus has been known to infect a phone via a WhatsApp call, and you don't even have to pick up the call for it to infect your phone. App developers are obviously constantly trying to patch these vulnerabilities, but they're always playing catch up. And where these attacks don't succeed, you can of course install Pegasus wirelessly if you're near the target, or even steal a mobile phone and install it that way as well. Once it's there, it has root access to your phone. That means it can do pretty much anything. It can read your messages, it can read your emails, it can look at all the photos, videos, and other media on your device. It can access your contacts. It knows where you are because of GPS, and probably the scariest for me is the fact that it can listen to your microphone and it can turn on your camera without you knowing. Not only that, it can read the keys you're typing. So it can read your keystrokes and will know every password you're typing into your phone.
It is absolutely frightening.
Trivia time. Question: WhatsApp's 2019 lawsuit claimed Pegasus targeted how many users through the missed call exploit? A, 140, B, 1400, C, 14,000, D, 140,000. And the answer is B, 1400. WhatsApp alleged around 1400 users were hit by Pegasus via a missed call exploit. A small number, but all were high value targets. Chapter 5, The Collateral Hack, It Wasn't Your Phone. Imagine this, you dump your phone, buy a new one, new SIM, new Apple ID. But days later, your contacts say, you sent me something weird. You didn't. Forensics reveal it wasn't even your phone that got hit. It was your driver's phone because his calendar synced with yours. Pegasus didn't need you. It only needed someone close enough to your digital shadow. Chapter 6, The Malware That Lived On. The reset didn't save you. You factory reset your phone thinking it's gone, but Pegasus often lives in temporary memory, RAM. When it deletes itself, it leaves no trace. Even a full reset doesn't guarantee safety, and if you restore your iCloud backup, you may reopen the door, because the vulnerability rides back in with old data. The terrifying part? Sometimes the only way out is new phone, new number, new life. Chapter 7, The Playbook of Defenders, How to Defend Like a Cyber Pro. Pegasus is government-grade spyware, but the lessons apply to us all. Update fast. Most Pegasus vectors were patched quickly by Apple WhatsApp. Use lockdown mode iOS, especially if you're a journalist, activist, or political figure. Minimize apps, less attack surface, fewer entry points. Compartmentalize, don't sync everything across personal, work, family devices. Educate your circle. Pegasus often infects your contacts to get to you. Seek expert forensics if you truly suspect compromise. Chapter 8, The Last Whisper, The Warning in the Silence. Pegasus proves that cybersecurity isn't about one device. It's about your entire ecosystem. Your people, your apps, your habits. It doesn't just break encryption, it breaks trust. So next time your phone buzzes with nothing there, remember, in today's world, silence can be the loudest warning of all. Closing CTA, decoding together. Thank you for tuning in to Decoding Cybersecurity. If this episode gave you some insights or taught you something new, please do like, share, and subscribe. I am Rakesh Nayam. Stay curious, stay skeptical, stay secure.